We are the roots that caught ground as a result of fallen seeds. It's not gender-based violence, it's barbaric violation of human beings. See, my college friend Lisa was left breathless at the hands of a ruthless barbarian. We placed her memories on a wall to hang on, so do allow me this time to mourn Elisa.
And that's how strong poetry can become in conveying messages on gender-based violence.
We need justice for Magdalena Stoffels, Lucia Shikongo, Tina Deje, and Shannon. Resentment spoke to me. Resentment spoke to me, clenching a fist and asked me, what right do I have to speak on women issues as a man if I carry the image of toxicity and the narrative that perpetuates violence, suggesting that somehow my loins are villainous, but I've brutally learned, in a heated argument, maintain silence.
About $6 million has been earmarked for the advocacy work and educational campaigns. The European Union has covered 75% of this cost, while the two local implementing partners will cover the remaining. Hope Initiative for Southern Africa, HISA Namibia branch, and a Finnish-based FXB International are implementing partners.
Partnership with our local partner, HISA Namibia, this grant will give us the capacity to act swiftly and also with a contextually sound approach to curbing GBV in informal settlements especially.
Part of the project or the packages that this program presents is going to tackle in the informal settlements the issues of toxic masculinity. It's going to ask the question, what do you think are the characteristics of a man? We will ask boys, to be a man in the informal settlements, what do you need to be? And that will help us to weed out toxic masculinity and also capacitate men and boys to be agents of change and also to be defenders of women and girls.
EU Ambassador to Namibia, Seneca Antila, underscored the need to educate men and boys on the importance of respecting their female folks to coexist.
The EU will stay in the forefront of this international mobilization to defend the rights of every woman and every girl to live free and safe. We do it for our future and our present, because women represent half of the society and are the pillar of just, open, developed and democratic societies. And nothing should deprive them of the freedom to play their role freely and safely.
While expressing EU's commitment in combating GBV, Antila noted that it is a global phenomenon that knows no social, economic and national boundaries, and it should be fought and denounced by all. The $6 million will be implemented in 3 years in the informal settlements of Tobias Hainyeko constituency, Groot-Aup and Five Rand at Okahanja, targeting 4,650 beneficiaries. But the art of music can still play a crucial role in fighting this ugly phenomenon. Jeff Tachihomino, NBC News, Windhoek.